Welcome back to another edition of Trial by Fire. I'm going to ask you a question. Do you know what I'm going to be doing today? If you guessed trying a sauce, then you're right. Today I am trying a sauce from a company that I have not done much with. I've tried a couple of their samples at a hot sauce festival. This is the Back 40. They're out of Bob Cajun, Ontario. And if that sounds familiar to some people who don't know Canada, and possibly, you know, Tragically Hip. They have a song, Bob Cajun. When I left your house this morning, it was a little loud tonight. It was in Bob Cajun, I saw the constellations reveal themselves one star at a time. Which... it's a really good song. But this one is a cinnamon hot sauce. I have tried, they have two versions of this. There's this one, and then they have their mild one. I tried the mild one at the festival, and I figured it was pretty decent, so I wanted to amp it up. And figured I'd get this one. Now, all I remember about it is that there's a cinnamon taste to it. It is gluten-free. I will have all of Back 40's information on here. It's a sweet whiskey heat, handcrafted Scotch bonnet base hot sauce. So I'm trying to read these really, really tiny ingredients list here. Scotch bonnets, stevia sweetener. I know that it says, it looks to me like it says insulin, but I know that's not right. But it's something soluble fiber. Organic stevia extract, red peppers, yellow peppers, apple cider vinegar, honey, garlic, cinnamon whiskey, and xanthan gum. So that the fiber one could be, it looks like M-U-L-I-N maybe, Mullen. I'll look it up on the website and have it up here for you guys. I just can't read that, even with glasses, I can't read that tiny, tiny print. Cause it's, yeah, it's minuscule. The joys of getting older, your eyes start to go. Take care of your eyes. And your teeth, and your whole body. Just take care of everything for you. It'll last longer. So, it's got... it's a, looks thin, but it also has like when the bubble moves. It moves pretty quick, but it's kind of got almost a sweet and sour kind of plum sauce, dragon sauce, or whatever it is that you call it, kind of consistency. Let's crack this open and give it a try. Smelling the Scotch bonnets right off. But there's the cinnamon in there. It's not as powerful like obviously like when you get cinnamon rolls or anything like that, but it's in there. It's it smells more like a cinnamon sugar as opposed to a cinnamon powder. It's almost got a sweetness to it, but that could be the mixture of everything else. So let's go on in and give it a try. So the Back 40 cinnamon. Now this has a fairly bit of a run. I can see little bits of red in it. I'm guessing that's probably pepper fragments. Well, obviously you guys can't see the bits in it, but I'm picking up on something else. That's why I'm trying to figure it out. Can't quite place it. But cheers to the cinnamon. Ooh. Cinnamon, I find, I don't know if everybody else does, it does kick up the heat a bit. Kind of because it's, okay. I don't know if I call it its own heat, but it's, yeah. I used to chew on cinnamon sticks back in high school and that, in elementary school, so it was, I love cinnamon, always have. It's good. The heat is, it's a pop of a heat. It's there and then it's gone. At least with what I had. Sadly, the flavor is the same way. It doesn't linger. Which would be nice to have at least one of them linger a little bit. Don't get me wrong, it's still good. Kind of coat my mouth with it. Yeah, a little bit more heat that time. I think obviously the second time around, a little bit more. But it's gone already. Got very, very tingle, like light, barely moving the needle tingle in my mouth right now. Just saying, hey, there was something there. Unfortunately, the cinnamon taste and any other flavoring was gone before even the heat dissipated. It'd be nice if it was stronger in the cinnamon, at least for me. It might be strong for other people. I love cinnamon. I've eaten it my entire life, straight and everything else. So I was one of those morons that did the cinnamon challenge when I was younger. Didn't do too bad with it, actually. But I think it helped that I've been eating cinnamon my entire life. But it's the heat, maybe a one. Flavor-wise, unfortunately, it's good flavor. Don't get me wrong, it is good flavor. It just doesn't last. So taking out the effect that it doesn't last, flavor-wise, I'd put it at about a 4. But if you're looking for something that you're going to enjoy the flavor on, with the fact that it dissipates so quickly, I think that would drop it down to maybe a 1.5. Is that dramatic of a drop from the base flavor to dissipating that? Yeah, for me anyways, it's kind of one of those, just can't get my head around it not being there. You want to be able to taste the sauce. Obviously you want to taste your food that you're putting it on too, but you're putting it on your food so you can taste it. And the fact that it dissipates so quickly, I could see if you were going to use this as a glaze or something, cook it onto something, it might work a bit better. But say putting it on wings or something, it just wouldn't work. But again, the back 40 from Bob Cage, Ontario, whiskey, Scotch bonnet, cinnamon hot sauce. Check out their website. They have quite a few different selections of stuff that they carry. But on that note, I think that's going to wrap it up for today. And thanks for watching. Don't forget to do the usual stuff. And we'll see you next time when I'll try who knows what. And enjoy the heat, stay spicy, and take care. I really wish it would have lasted longer.